Hi, Assalamu Alaikum. Today let's see how we can prepare a South Indian style of papad or pappadam at home. Homemade version of pappadam is always tastier and clean compared to the store bought. The only difficult part in the pappadam is the kneading. So if you could give a little effort, you could eat clean and healthy pappadams at home. So the main ingredient is urud dal. This dal I have already washed. And then after draining, I have allowed this to dry completely. This is well dried. Next step is to finely powder the dal. After powdering, you can sieve it well. Instead of doing this process, you can also buy powdered urud dal, which is easily available. But I don't recommend it as it won't be much clean. Now from the powdered dal, I have taken exactly 1 cup, just to give a correct measurement. Next add 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Next add salt, here I am adding almost around 1/2 teaspoon. Next for a nice taste, I am adding here some asafoetida, that's around 1/2 teaspoon. For a different taste, you can also add some ajwain or carom seeds, but try adding only the powder, not the whole. Now give this a good mix, and the next process is the kneading. Here we will be adding water little by little. Do not add all at a time because we need a very hard dough, not a soft dough. So here at a time I'm adding only 2 tablespoons, then mixing, and then if needed you can add more and more and mix. So here I've added around 5 to 6 tablespoons of water, and while kneading you can dip your hands in water and knead. Our dough has to be hard but still soft inside. After kneading for 2 to 3 minutes, then you can add around 1 teaspoon of oil. You can either use sesame oil or even coconut oil and knead again. So for kneading I'm taking the help of my husband, he's going to knead the dough. So you can just press it like this and then knead. In between you can dip your hands in water and then knead. Ultimately we need this to be a soft dough. Never add too much water in the beginning and make this a soft dough. By kneading it has to be soft. See, now after kneading it is soft by touching but still hard. Now you can make this dough like this and divide into equal portions. Divide the dough big or small as per the size of your pappadam. Here I'm not keeping it very big, just a medium, and some of them very small. To roll out the dough, use all-purpose flour. Make sure that you dust with enough flour, else it will start to stick. After rolling, then to give a good shape, you can just cut them using a cutter. Next, this pappadams has to be dried in sunlight. So here I have placed them on a tray and left it to dry for at least 2 minutes on each side. Do not keep them more than 5 minutes, else it will turn to be hard. And one puff up while frying. Instead of drying this in sunlight, you can also allow this to dry inside your oven. Instead of frying, to make it healthy, you can also grill the pappadams. Papadams are always a good combination for Kerala meals or even salads, and a beautiful combination with Kerala style biryani. So hope you have enjoyed today's simple video. Stay tuned for more yummy recipes. Take care. Bye-bye.